Tonight's foolishness will be accompanied by Get Up Off of That Thang, a soulful brown ale from Devil May Care Brewing in Winnipeg. Not much to say about this one. I've had it before. They describe it as just a hearty, deep, full of character, soulful sort of beer. And I agree, it's quite nice and roasty. So today, I am going to be, by popular request, doing a teardown of this cheap, crappy, yet overpriced Bluetooth speaker that I got in a mailbag a few weeks back. I'll put a link up there if you're interested in seeing the history of this thing. It says it's a Bluetooth speaker, and it is, but it also has a USB input and an SD card input. It has USB charging input, which is also labeled as auxiliary. I'm not quite sure how that works, and since there was no manual with it, I haven't been able to figure it out. It can act also as a Bluetooth speakerphone, and I don't know. Well, let's just fire it up and see what happens here. Makes noise.
Bluetooth mode.
Very bad English recording. It says Bluetooth mode. Let's try the USB.
USB driver mode.
Turn the volume down on my YouTube copyright-free music. So it has on the side of it fast forward or jump ahead, jump back buttons, a play pause button, which also acts as your Bluetooth call answer button, and it has a mode button. Let me just pause that and also throw in the SD card here.
SD card mode.
And she's announcing it again. And there we have it playing off there. So now if we go through the modes.
Bluetooth mode. FM mode.
It seems to have an FM radio in it. But I haven't been able to get it to lock onto a channel or anything. That's just voluming. I don't know.
AUX mode.
AUX mode, auxiliary mode. I assume that's getting some audio in somehow through the USB cord, but I haven't tried to figure out how that works. And then
USB driver mode.
Back to USB mode again. Pull that out.
SD card mode. Bluetooth mode.
It's kind of neat that it changes modes as sources become available or unavailable. So it's got lots of functions, but also, as you heard, it sounds like crap, which I guess that shouldn't really surprise me for just a cheap random thing off eBay. But listening to it or using it isn't why we're here. I want to get inside it and see what's going on inside. There's no obvious fasteners, and twisting it like that does nothing. So I think the first thing I'm going to try and do is pry this little foamy bit off the bottom to see if there's any screws underneath there. Oh, I found one already. Found two. Good. Feel like kind of gummy little self-tappers. I guess that makes sense. In a cheap product, you wouldn't expect something machined and tapped or anything. Okay, so the bottom comes off there. We have the circuit board. We have a little battery there, which is not puffy. That's a good start. And then we have two wires going up into the little cavity for the speaker itself. Okay. Will that come off relatively painlessly? Yeah. Not puffy on the back. And I'm not seeing a protection circuit board on there. Let's be careful not to short those. Thank you. Fairly straightforward little design, at least on this side. We have a crystal. We have an LED. Some pushy buttons. We have a couple of surface mount chips. So a diode over there, the USB connector, the SD card thing, a switch, and another connector. And does that just, oh, it does just pop out. Okay, well, that's easy. What's holding it? The speaker's holding it. I mean, the switch is holding it. All right. There's that. There's nothing on the back. Wow. that's all there is to it. Just a single-sided board. This is the last time you saw a single-sided board in a modern product. So we've got a 26.0 megahertz crystal that will be clocking the Bluetooth chip, no doubt, which is some sort of a processor, I would guess. The small chip over here calls itself an NS8002. And it's right beside some really horrible soldering on the wires that go to the speaker.
Well, that makes sense. The NS8002 is a bridged audio power amplifier with a 5-volt working voltage. It can do 3 watts into a 3-ohm load with less than 10% distortion. 10% distortion is nothing to brag about, really. But anyway, it looks like it just needs a handful of support components. This would be the feedback resistor, input load resistor, input DC blocking capacitor. It'll pull up on its bias input here. Sure. Just a fairly straightforward little amplifier.
And then the main chip, I don't recognize that manufacturer logo, but it is PNEA? Is it a backward 9 or some other symbol? PN something A15E7E. Clearly just following the traces, that is the main chip. It is connected to the crystal. It is connected to the LED. And it is connected to the Bluetooth antenna. Must be a fair bit going on inside there. I'm assuming it's a purpose-designed chip just for music players, but it's got to be a USB host for this guy. It's got to be an SD card host for this guy. It has to, does it communicate with that? Or, I didn't try that. Wonder if it can be used as a USB hub or a USB card reader or something from there. Let's look closer at those data lines. No, it doesn't look like those data lines on that USB connector go anywhere. So that confuses me even more. Why is it labeling that as DC 5 volts and auxiliary? I don't get that at all. And the other thing, this thing claims to be a Bluetooth speakerphone, but I'm not seeing a microphone down here anywhere. So does that mean that it is using the speaker in here as a microphone as well? That would mean half duplex audio, wouldn't it? Interesting. I guess I shouldn't be too surprised that I wasn't able to find anything about this larger chip. It's clearly purpose designed for this, clearly fairly specialized, and clearly not intended for tinkerers like us. Oh well. I guess that's not really a big surprise. So I was initially thinking that this LED connected the light pipe up in here or something, but I don't think it does. I think it just sort of shines up into there in general. And another thing that I noticed observing it for a while, this little RGB LED here only has one connection to the microcontroller or whatever it is through this little 10 ohm resistor. So I don't think it's an addressable LED. I think it's just one of those self-flashing LEDs. And one way to find out is to just connect the battery through a resistor to that LED and see what happens. Quick flashes, slow flashes, quicker flashes, all the way through the different colors, and then back to that again. And that's not with the whole circuit powered, that's just with that LED, again, getting a direct connection to the battery through this resistor. That's a nifty find. I've got a few different self-flashing LEDs, but not in surface mount. Other things worthy of note, this little cell here is, like I said, just a little lithium battery of some description. There is no markings at all on the package, but it obviously doesn't have a huge milliamp hour capacity, and it doesn't have any protection. And I don't see any circuitry on here for charging it or anything. I think there's just that diode in there and this connection. which is odd. Maybe a resistor or two in there as well as a voltage divider. Yeah, there is a resistor in series to the battery from that diode. So that is fairly poorly done charging. Wouldn't be happy with that at all. Not a lot else to say about this other than repeating how impressed I am that this little chip here has so many functions going on. But regardless of how interesting that anonymous little chip there is, it's still a really cheap, bad sounding speaker, and I doubt that I'll be using it for anything other than, I suppose, if I need a speaker for some, you know, sacrificial purpose, I'll use this. I guess to be complete, I should probably crack into where that speaker itself is. I wonder if I can get in this way. Oh, that was too easy. Okay, so there is the speaker cone. Can I lift it out without punching through the paper? Maybe. Oh, it's mostly just friction and a little bit of adhesive. Okay, so does it say anything on the back of it? No, just YL. It clearly is a magnet. It's not a very powerful magnet. It doesn't have to be. The amplifier circuit said it could work with a 3-ohm load. So I'm going to guess this is probably a 4-ohm speaker. And just a cheap little one. Not a lot of throw to it. You know, not impressive on its own. I suppose if you needed a little speaker just to hide someplace, it might be okay. But I got smaller speakers around here. I think I've sort of exhausted my amusement with this one. Yeah. Certainly not worth what I paid for it. You could probably find a speaker like this at the dollar store, and that would likely be worth the price then. I don't know. Anyway, that was fun. I hope you found that vaguely amusing, slightly informative, a little bit entertaining. I don't know. Good waste of time for a few minutes. Anyway, thanks for watching. Questions and comments down below as usual. Don't know what I'm getting up to next week, but I'm sure it'll be following my curiosity as usual. Talk to you later.